Konnichiwa. Genki desu ka? We are going to do basically really tiny little reviews on most of the bats that I have. The reason why is a lot of times, you look at some of these older bats and they're, you know, obviously they're a lot cheaper because they're the previous models or whatever. But you want to see, you know, a review on them, or you want to see people hitting with them, and most of the time you don't see that kind of stuff because the people that tend to be either mostly sponsored are getting the newer bats, so you really don't get a chance to actually see some of these older models, and that can be kind of a drag when it comes to deciding whether you want to put out however much money it is for a bat, especially online, without getting a chance to actually physically use it. So that's where I come in, and I have majority of my bats are old models. So if you happen to run across these models, at least you have some sort of a review you can go by. Most of the bats, I'm gonna review, I've used in my videos, so you can actually physically see them. You just have to look through them. I think only one I haven't used in a video, but I'll try to get around to doing that one day. Obviously, this is just my opinion, so you really can't really base it on just what I think. I'm a completely different hitter from other people. Other people hit it differently than, you know, those people. It's, you just take this as a way to kind of like help further formulate your opinion on what. You know, the bat might do for you. I try to think from all different kinds of perspectives, from the power hitters to the contact hitters and so on and so forth. So just keep that in mind. So we're going to do, to start with something that I don't think you can really even use these in most leagues anymore. But this is the Lousiville Slugger Bomber. Made in the USA. With the original stinging rubber grip. This is actually a short bat. I think this one is a 33 inch, and then it says it's 4 ounces less, so this would be, what, 29? This does not feel like it's 29, though. I've only used this a few times. Like I said, if you don't hit the correct spot on this thing, oh my god. They sting. Aluminum bats tend to sting, and this is a true aluminum bat in the sense that there's no gimmicks or nothing. It's just an aluminum bat with the rubber little handle. Okay. So I've got a couple things that I'm gonna try to rate them on. There's other things that people rate on bats, but these are just the generic ones that I tend to see a lot. So price wise. I don't even know how much these things went for originally, but I found this one for $7 at a flea market over in Oakland, swap meet over in Oakland. So for the price, if you're allowed to use these, because I'm not even allowed to use these in my league because it doesn't have the stamp, which is pretty stupid because these things don't really hit very hard. But for the price, I mean, hey, if you're looking for a good batting practice bat or something you want to use in the against a pitching machine, because you should not use your composite bats in a pitching machine. It'll mess your pitching. It'll mess your bat up because the pitching machine balls are designed to be dense and heavy and strong, and bats aren't designed to go up against something that's that dense and strong. These are pretty much indestructible, so you could always use these for that. You could use these for those. Total control balls, the heavy balls. What else could you use these for? That's pretty much it. But I mean, these are good just BP pads because you can't break them. But man, I would definitely get, if you did get one of these things, I would definitely rewrap it because this rubber handle stuff is no joke. But I mean, if you're okay with the sting, it kind of tells you if you're hitting it right or if you're not hitting it right. Pop. It's a single wall aluminum bat. I mean, you're really not going to get a whole lot of power out of these things. You have to put a lot more effort to get it to go the distance. You know, that's the thing about these composite bats nowadays is you really don't have to hit it very hard to get it to go far, but these ones you do. So I really wouldn't give the pop too high marks, you know, in terms of marks. Distance, same thing. You know, I mean, you're really not going to get much distance out of this. You can probably slap some infield shots, you know, through the gap. But other than that, not a whole lot. Feel, I'm not particularly fond of aluminum bats. I don't like the way aluminum bats feel because they're usually pretty stiff. I like to have a little bit of give, so that way I rely on the feedback of the barrel flexing or not flexing to know if I hit the ball well or not. I don't really like the sting. If I get a sting on a composite bat, it means I really didn't hit it right. But if I got a stiff response, I know I didn't hit it in the right spot. Or I also know if the bat's starting to open up too. Then these ones, you don't get that. At least with these ones, you don't get that. The sound, I mean, it's an aluminum bat. If you like the aluminum bat sound, it'll definitely make that sound. But, you know, I mean, it's got that aluminum sound. I guess that's kind of nice. I don't know why people judge on sound. I never understood that. Durability, obviously this is top notch. You're not going to break these things. This bat is probably from the 70s, maybe the early 80s. And it's still in good shape, you know. These things don't crap out on you. So again, they're good for BP if you want to beat the living shit or practice your bat flips. I mean, you could practice your bat flips. Looks, usually these are nothing special, but this one's got nice graphics. I kind of like that bomber. That's the reason I bought it. I like that bomber look, you know. But outside of that, I mean, these are not the most attractive looking bats in the world, unless you're into that old nostalgic, you know, aluminum bat look. This reminds me of growing up watching my parents play, but it's not the most eye-catching of designs, you know, these old aluminum ones. Sweet spot. I mean, I really can't even tell where it is. There really isn't so much a sweet spot when it comes to these, but, you know, usually your sweet spot's probably right about... Or right about in that area. Again, it doesn't hit very well, so I wouldn't really even say it has a sweet spot. But that's the nature of these ones. So those are the things that I normally try to base the bats on. Again, I mean, you can find any of these Lousiville Slugger metal aluminum bats for cheap. I just recommend them for batting practice, or if you're gonna use a batting cage, you probably want to go with one of these. Or you can get a cheaper, newer aluminum bat, which I'll show you in the next episode. But, it is what it is. Like I said, if you're nostalgic and you want to rock the three-quarter shirts, you know, and kind of get in there like that, old school, cool. But otherwise, they're not really worth it. You can't use them in most leagues, so best for just the shelf. But that's the Lousiville Slugger Bomber. So hopefully you watch this episode first, because I kind of did my little spiel about, okay, again, don't, my opinion is just my opinion. Everyone is different. Everyone's got different preferences and all that stuff. But there's your review on the Lousiville Slugger Bomber. So I still got, six more bats to go. So I will see you in the next episode, which now you can go and look at whatever you want. I'm not doing this again, the spiel thing. So, see you guys next time.